Good morning, Key Stage 2, and welcome to your first PE lesson of the year. It's not quite how we imagined, but, you know, we've got to get on with things. I am in my living room. There's not a great deal of space. I've moved all of my children's toys to one side, so if you can see over there, it's like an absolute tip, but I think we've got enough room. I know some of you are in your classes at the moment. Some of you will be at home right now. All I ask is if you're going to join in this video, just make sure you've got enough space around you. We're going to try and limit most things to the spot, so there isn't a great deal of movement around your rooms, but just make sure around you you've got enough space. Put your arms out, put your feet out, etc. This is going to be a 30-minute lesson. It's going to be fitness-based themed because, again, we don't know how much equipment that we do have in our homes, and we won't have a great deal in our classrooms, so we're trying to limit that. So it'll be fitness-based. I've got my stopwatch up here for 30 minutes. There'll be 10 exercises. We're going to work for 40 seconds and have 20 seconds rest, and we're going to repeat that twice. So that's 20 minutes of workout, and then we've got a warm-up and a cool-down to incorporate that. And that should take us into our 30 minutes with a short break in the middle. So I will play the stopwatch. Hopefully it starts. Perfect, that's counting down. It's probably backwards for you, but we'll see. And just on the spot, just start moving. So just start walking on the spot, just start to get your blood pumping around your body, start to get your muscles warm, and start preparing yourself for the activities to come. Okay, just turn that into a really slow jog now. Just on the spot, really, really slow jogging. And we'll do this until we get to 29 minutes. Good. 5 seconds. Okay, good. So just back into your walk. So just keep your feet moving. This session's going to have a bit of a theme, and it's going to be working our abdominals. Now, our abdominal muscles are in the middle of our body here. These are our abs that we abbreviate them to make them a little bit shorter. So the things we're going to be doing today is going to be working those abs a little bit. Not every single exercise. We'll be giving your abs a little bit of a break. But most of it, and we're going to try and have a different muscle each time that we're going to focus on, which is going to help us to learn about the human body, which is really, really important as well. 20 second jog, let's go. A little bit quicker than last time, a little bit quicker. It's still a warm up, so we're not going flat out, just a bit faster than we was doing before. 10 seconds, good. 3, 2, 1, good, and relax. Right, we'll warm up for one more minute and then we'll start our main session. So just to get us going, we're just going to flick our heels up behind. Heel flicks. That's good. Five seconds. Good, okay. High knees. So on the spot, knees a little bit higher. Really good. Ten seconds to go. Five. Good, well done everybody, good start. So we're feeling a little bit warmer, so now we're ready to start our main session. Like I say, 10 exercises. For Key Stage 2 children, we're going to work for 40 seconds and then have 20 seconds rest. So every single minute we will work to that. 40 seconds of hard work, 20 seconds of rest. There'll be 10 exercises and we'll repeat that twice. Okay, good. So, 30 seconds more rest period, and then we're going to start. Try and encourage your grown-ups to join in as well, so that includes the teachers in your classroom. If they're there, if they're standing at the back just watching right now, let's get them involved, and any grown-ups or any siblings at home. 10 seconds. So the first exercise will be a jumping jack. There. Okay, so remember, 40 seconds and then 20 rest. Let's go. Keep going. I'm actually on my mat. Good. Ten seconds left. Three, two, one. Good. So this rest period now for 20 seconds. And when we start back again, mountain climb is really good for your abdominal strength. So we'll be down low, one foot in front of the other, driving that knee into the chest. Let's go, 40 seconds. If at any point you need to rest during the minute, just take your breather so you can just stop, get your breath back, start again. Ten seconds. You'll be really feeling this in your stomach muscles. Two, one. Good. Well done, everyone. Breather. If you've got your water near you, you can use these 20-second periods to have a drink, but there will be a break halfway through, like I say. Next exercise, plank hold. So down on your forearms, on your toes, lifting that body off the ground ever so slightly, not too far. Let's see how long we can hold that for. If we need to break the hold, we just stop and then we can come in again. Some of you will be able to do it for the whole 40 seconds, I'm sure. Just try your best. 10 seconds. Good. Okay, next exercise when we start back will be squats. So I would say feet just further than shoulder width. We're going to bend down, try and get our bottom in line with our knee. Let's try and keep our knees in line with our heels, not going over our toes if we can. Let's go. Ten seconds, guys. Good. Bit of fire burn going on there now. Right, your favourite. Brilliant for the core. Burpees. So it's into a squat thrust position. Out, in, and a jump. If you want to go out and in, you can stand and stretch, makes it a little bit easier. If you don't have much space in your classroom, you can touch your toes and do a jump, toe touch, do a jump, and that way you're not using as much space. 5 seconds. Good. 20 seconds rest. Going to be going down low for this one. It's a Russian twist. It's a stomach exercise. So feet up off the floor and we're going to twist from side to side. If you need to make it easier, keep your feet on the floor, keep your heels on the floor, still turning. Good, turning at the shoulders, right the way around, feeling that burn in your tummy muscles there. Fifteen seconds. Focus on your breathing, in through your nose, in oxygen in. 2, 1, and stop. Good. A brilliant muscle for your stomach. Brilliant exercise for your stomach muscle, sorry. Okay, we're going to jump out. Back pedal to our spot. So jump out. Back pedal. Now, depending on the space, can depend on how long your jump will be. Really bend your knees on landing, keep yourself safe. Jump forward and back. If you don't have any room to jump forward, you might need to adapt that slightly. 10 seconds. Good, well done. And next exercise on the spot will be a fast paced jog. Okay, really fast, quicker than what we was doing in the warm up. Okay, let's go. 40 seconds, quicker pace. Pump them arms. Remember your breathing. Good, keep going, hit that pace, 15 seconds. Five to go. Good, well done. Coming to the end of this first set now. So like when we was doing our burpees, we had a squat thrust. So we was down on hands and feet and it was out and in. Continuous. Another good exercise for our stomach. Let's go. Alexa, skip. Won't feel you now. We've got 20 seconds, keep it going. Ten seconds to go, I'm in mat trouble. Good, well done. Good. So last exercise for the first set, call it a crab ab. Because we go down in a crab position. So tummy facing the ceiling, hands and feet. And then it's right hand to left foot. Alternate. It's easier when our bottom is down on the ground. Harder, bottom raised. Brilliant for your core strength. Good. 20 seconds. Ten to go. Okay, stop there, guys. Good. So that is 10 exercise. So that is round one. So use this opportunity now to get a drink, have a couple of minutes breather, and then we will go back into the same 10 exercises. So your abdominals are in the centre of your body, and we call this the body's core. Core, often found in the centre of things. So our core muscles are all the muscles round the back. We sometimes call that the trunk of the body. So just have a think during the break, what else do we find has a core in its centre or in the middle? What else do you know that will have a core in the middle? The human body does, which is what we're learning today. What else? Right, when we start again, we're going to go now for 30 seconds on, 30 seconds off. So we've got one more minute of the rest period. Make sure you're telling your adult and you're having conversations about core and what things that we find have a core in the middle. And then if you've already given some answers there, why is core strength in a person important? So what benefits do we have if we have a strong core? So if the center of your body is strong and your muscles are strong, what advantages in life or in sport is that going to give you? Just have a chat for 20 seconds. You can discuss this with your grown-up at home as well. So 30 seconds for the jumping jacks. Okay, so ready to go. 30 seconds this time. A slightly longer rest in this next set. Seconds. Good. 30 seconds rest. So what advantages does core strength give you? Straight away, it will give you really, really good balance. Okay, so if you've got a strong middle of your body, center of your body is strong, the balance is going to be very good. So all sportsmen that require balance, which is a lot of them, will want to maintain a strong core. Okay, mountain climbers, 30 seconds. Down on our hands. Let's go. As we're working for shorter time, if we can speed it up a little bit now. Five seconds. Good. So a strong core will help me with my posture as well. So even when I'm standing, okay, for that good posture, strong core is going to help and support me. Remember, the abdominals that we're working on today is more around the front. So our abdominals are here. We have different muscles around the back, which we'll be learning as the weeks go on. Okay, 30 seconds plank hold. Let's see if we can do it. Those people that could do it last time, really easy. Just one leg raise, down. Alternate, down, good. This is tricky. So this is for the people that could hold it for the length of time last time out. Good. So remember to encourage your grown-ups to get involved. Let's not have anybody standing around. I know Mr. Thomas will be joining him right now. Never misses an opportunity to get involved. Okay, 30 seconds of burpees, next up. Let's go. Good. 5 seconds. Well done. Good. Long rest. 30 seconds. Then we'll be into our squats. So remember with your squat, feet just past shoulder width. Let's go down. Well done. Try and keep those knees in line with our heel. We don't want our knees going over our toes. Good. Try and keep those back and shoulders upright. So we're feeling it here. 10 seconds. 5 to go. Good, well done. Right, next one, the Russian twists, remember, was down on the ground. So again, just make sure you've got that little bit of space around you. Moving objects if you have to. So it was a turn at the shoulder with feet up harder or down slightly easier. Let's go. Ten seconds. Good. We've got 4 more activities to do now on this set. So the next one was our jump out, bending those knees and returning back to your place. Again, just make sure you've got enough space around you for this, please. Let's go, jump out, return. Back, it's really good. 10 seconds. Well done, guys. Good. 30 seconds rest. So fast jog on the spot. 30 seconds. Alexa, turn it up. Need some inspiration. Right, let's go. 30 seconds. Quicker on the spot. Good. Keep it going. 5 seconds. Excellent job, everyone. Good. So 2 more left. The The squat thrusts are next. Two exercises to finish, both very good for core strength. Remember the benefits. Okay, down on your hands. Out and in, let's go, good. Keep going. Five seconds. Good, well done. Getting too old for this, Joe, I think. Be soon time for a younger model stood up here. Can start to feel it now. Okay, so last one before we cool down is our crab ad. We're in the crab position. Tummy's facing the ceiling. Alternating hands to feet. Right hand, left foot, let's go. We'll make it easier by sitting, harder lifting ourselves off the ground. Working that core. Ten seconds. Good, well done everyone. Excellent job. That's two rounds of our 10 exercises. You can have a drink. Really good effort this morning. So I'm assuming you're doing this, it's after lunch, it's in the afternoon. Because obviously you've got some lessons in the morning to do first. So a really, really good way to finish the day by having a workout. And I will be back to do lots more of these. So they will be coming thick and fast just to keep us active during to this next period of lockdown we've got until, we know, probably till middle of February at the moment. So it's important that we maintain our fitness and our healthy lifestyles. You've been working incredibly hard with the Daily Mile, and your fitness levels across the whole academy has really improved. And we just want to try and keep ourselves ticking over by doing these exercises to keep us going. I heard Joe Wicks is back next week. If you thought this was better, stick with me and I'll be doing them. But if you wanted to do extra, if you've got lots of energy, I know Joe Wicks is coming back 3 days a week to do some home workouts as well. All jokes aside, they are fantastic and it'll just give you something a little bit different to what we're doing and we're offering right now. So just in the cool down, just a slow jog, nice and slow. And again, I mentioned it before, just focus on your breathing in through your nose, getting that oxygen back into your body. You've got a nice rest. I've got to now film another one of these for key stage one, and I'm sweating already. Might have to do it outside in the rain next time. It's good. Okay, 20 seconds. Just keep your feet moving, just into a slow walk this time. Just slowing the pace down. Fingertips now, we're going to go down to our toes. Just have a stretch. Try and keep your legs as straight as you possibly can. Just hold that position. Okay, that's good. So just tell your adult that's near you, what is the name of the group of muscles that make up the stomach? What are they called? They're shortened to something that you probably would all have heard of. until you're adult in the room, one key benefit of strong core muscles. I won't say the name of them yet until you've answered the question. So one benefit from having a strong core is till you're adult. Okay, good. So well done to the people that said the name of the stomach muscles collectively was the abdominals. I've heard them as called the abs, the abdominals, and key benefits, posture and balance. Because a strong trunk, strong core will give us that and will support our whole body because it's in the centre. Okay, so I just want you to, if you get any free time, just have a look to see what is the biggest muscle in the human body, the biggest muscle. And it doesn't matter if you're a child, if you're a grown up, this muscle will be the biggest in your body. Have a little look, what is it? And that is going to be the theme to our next workout. But I just want you to do a little bit of research for me. You can do it if you've got any free time in class now. What is the name of the biggest muscle in the human body? And that is 30 minutes. Well done to everybody, and we'll see you next time. Really, really good session. Stay safe.